Polymyositis is diagnosed by a series of invasive and non-invasive testing. One of the first things that the doctor will do is to confirm the patient's complaint of weakness. If the patient is saying that they're weak, we would do a physical exam quantifying their strength. Once proximal muscle strength is found to be weak, we would go on further to do blood tests. So the next thing would be ascertaining a patient's muscle enzymes. That can be something called a creatine kinase, or a CK, or an aldolase. In some circumstances, even something that is usually known as liver function tests, which are erroneously named really because they can also come from the muscle, can be found to be elevated. So we would check those as well. The next level of testing involves something called an EMG, which stands for an electromyogram. An EMG is a semi-invasive testing in which needles are placed in to the patient's muscle to determine whether or not the electrical activity is thought to be normal. If the muscles show what's called a pattern of irritability, that can be a clue that the muscles are affected this way. The final thing that is usually done is a muscle biopsy. Muscle biopsy is usually done to confirm the diagnosis, to look for features of inflammation in the muscle. Also, in today's more sophisticated age, we now have muscle-specific autoantibodies, which essentially is a test to show that patients maybe have very specific abnormal immune proteins that show us that their body is responding inappropriately to their own muscles. These certain autoantibodies are very specific for myositis and can clue us into the diagnosis.